LibreOffice Draw has 5 different ways or variations of creating 3D objects. The 5 variations fall into one of 2 types of 3D objects. They're 3D bodies, which we have 3 variations of creation, and 3D shapes, which we have 2 variations of creation. We're going to look at the 3D body variations in this tutorial. The first way we're going to look at is called extrusion. And to do that, I'm going to add a rectangle onto the screen. I'm going to hit Ctrl-C, Ctrl-V to make a copy. And I'm using my right arrow to move it over to the right. Now, the one on the right that's selected, this is the one we're going to extrude. To do that, I go into Modify, Convert to 3D. And from here, if I click on it again, we get our rotation handles. I can rotate it from the corners just like I can a regular shape. And if I rotate from one of these center shapes, we can see the 3D rotation. In order to identify what we did, this is variation 1, extrusion. This is a 3D body. We inserted a shape and then went to modify, convert to 3D. The second way we're going to look at to create a 3D object is I'm going to insert our rectangle again. Control C, Control V, and using my right arrow, bringing this over. With this selected, again, I'm going up into Modify, Convert to 3D Rotation Object. And from here, we see this looks like a cylinder. If we try this with a different shape, maybe a triangle, Control C, Control V, and using my arrow. Now I'm going up into Modify, Convert to 3D Rotation Object, and we see this time it becomes a cone. So with our rectangle, the left side is the center and the right side is the outside edge. The same thing with our cone. Our angle is the outside edge and our line is the center. In order to make this just a little clearer, I'm going to add a shape that looks like a martini glass. I'm going to use Control C, Control V, move it over to the right, and go up into Modify, Convert to 3D Rotation Object. So here we can see that it took our single line and created multiple versions around in 360 degrees, giving us our martini glass. This is variation 2, a rotation, method 1. This is also a 3D body. We inserted the shape, and this side we modify, convert to 3D rotation object. I'm going to add a rectangle, just like we just did. Control C, Control V, using the arrow over. This time, instead of going into Modify, I'm going to come down to our Effects Mode toolbar. Now, we skipped this one when we were looking at the Effects Mode. This is in 3D Rotation Object. And you might think this is the same thing as Modify, Convert to 3D Rotation Object. If we look closely, we see on this icon, it's got a little arrow on it. Our icon on the Effects Mode toolbar does not have that arrow. With my object selected, I'm going to click on the icon, and it gives us a line very similar to what we had in our flip from the Effects Mode toolbar. I can grab the corners and move it. I can also just move these apart. After I do that, I'm going to put my arrow onto my selected shape and click on it. And here, when I rotate it, we see we've got a cylinder with a hole in the center. If I change my rectangle, make it really thin, Control C, Control V, and moving it over with the arrow, I'm going to hit that rotate again, move this apart a little bit, putting the arrow over my selected shape. Now we've got a tube, and angling it down, we can see right through the tube. The next thing I want to try is a circle. Control C, Control V, moving this over. Clicking on our in 3D rotation object, moving the line over, clicking on this selected shape, and now we've got a torus, or a donut, as some people might think of it. I'm going to do the same thing, making our martini glass again, coming in, coming down, coming out a little at the bottom. This time I'm going to make the line a little thicker. Control C, Control V, moving the line over. And I'm clicking on our in 3D rotation object. I want to move the line just a little bit. Clicking on the original. And let's change that color. Maybe we'll make it blue. So this is our variation 2 rotation method 2. We inserted our shape, then from our effects mode toolbar, we made our 3D object from it. And this is again a 3D body. The third way of inserting a 3D body is probably the easiest because it's just adding in a shape from our 3D objects toolbar. And those get inserted in just like we do any shape. And if you want to change these colors, we just go up to the color. So here's our variation 3, inserting ready-made 3D shapes from the toolbar. And this again is a 3D body. Thank you.